You probably have already read Good to Great, 4-Hour Workweek, 0 to 1. Those are great books. But a lot of times to get advantage in life, you have to read the books that a lot of other people aren't reading. I'm gonna give you my favorite books that you've probably never heard of, but it'll help you with a lot of specific problems you're facing in your business. Let's dive in. Make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell, ding, because I will be posting weekly subscriber-only content such as link to my office hours, behind the scenes of things that are going on in my business, as well as freebies and goodies for subscribers only. So if you don't want to miss out, you need to make sure you hit that subscribe button and that little bell, ding, so YouTube will make sure you get notified every single time. I love you, and I'll see you out there. Problem number one, how to build a million-dollar one-person business with the skills you already have. My book recommendation is Million Dollar Consulting by Alan Weiss. So takeaway number one is value-based pricing. And I still do this to this day. The way you think about it is that if you're going as a consultant or if you're being a software provider, like you do on AppSumo.com, it's how much money am I making for my client? And that is how you charge them, not by hourly. So many people, when they're doing freelancing or services, they're like, 20 bucks an hour to do this. It's like, well, how much value are you actually creating for that person? And if it's actually in the hundreds of thousands or millions or whatever amount, you can actually charge the fixed fee. That's way higher than any hourly you could do. So really be thinking about, how do I approach things as a value-based pricing, not just like, oh, everyone else charges hourly, so I'm gonna follow along with the sheep. So I really love that that book talked about that. Have you ever gone and tried to buy something from someone and they actually tell you you can't buy it? They're like, hey, this is probably not good for you. What's your immediate thought? They're like, I trust this person. They're telling me what's actually good for me. And I think this is really something powerful that he talks about in the book about needs versus wants. There's a lot of customers or people when they come to me for marketing advice, like, how do you market this product? I'm like, I think you actually have a business problem. Let's really talk about that. Really think about what does the person need and what is best for the business and really focusing on that. Because what that'll also do, going back to takeaway number one, is you could charge more because you'll likely be solving a more important problem for them. Problem number two, how to get customers for your business. So my book recommendation, I've talked about this for years. I'm good friends with his daughter. Is Ultimate Sales Machine by Chet Holmes. And this is one of those books that I tell everyone about. It's got a lot of meaty nuggets. It's definitely one of the core materials that I've used to figure out, one, how to be productive in business, as well as how to be a better salesperson, which as we talked about from the first book recommendation, sales is almost everything you're doing, convincing people or talking to people or educating people. So if you can improve your sales skills, which this book is one of the best out there, highly recommend it. So one of the key things about sales that I think about from this book specifically is that instead of selling someone, think about the sales process as an education process. So you're not actually like, come buy this thing or come buy this, whatever it is. It's actually saying, hey, let me understand what you need and educate you if what I'm selling is actually gonna be beneficial and really even doing education through your marketing. So if you think about a lot of marketing today, it's YouTube videos or there's eBooks or there's free tools and you educate people, which then makes them likely to trust you to finally buy your product. Oh, one more thing from this book that's fire is the Dream 100. So specifically, a lot of people come and they say, Noah, how do I do marketing? And I've spent tens of millions of dollars on Facebook and Google ads and a lot more over the years. And what happens is people want to scale and do all this really fancy ass marketing. And I'm like, well, why don't you make a list of your next 100 customers? Who's the Dream 100 you want? And what you realize is you're like, oh, I could just go directly after them instead of building a landing page or doing other email marketing. Just make your Dream 100 list. Or if you're just getting started, make it a Dream 10 list. And I think that's, you know, something I've talked about in this channel is hand-to-hand combat marketing. And that literally, I think, was the inspiration for a lot of this, which is just make a list of who your exact people are and then go directly after them. Don't try to do a bunch of other fancy things. Just go right directly to the outcome. So make your Dream 100 list. I love that. One last thing from this book that honestly is one of the, if I had to hire for two things in life, this is one of the most important things, which is follow through. I can't tell you how many emails I get, hey, can I blog for you? Or hey, can you do this thing? And I delete it just to kind of see who actually follows up. And it's literally 99% almost never do. And 1% of you, hopefully it's gonna be you who is watching this, is following up and following through. And so Chet Holmes talks a lot about that. So whatever you can do in your own life to be able to follow through better will definitely make you a lot more successful. Problem number three, how to hire great people and let them run the business for you. Now this book, when I started my own entrepreneurial journey, in 2007, this book really inspired how I run and lead companies. Maverick by Ricardo Semler. He also has a podcast with Tim Ferriss. I'd highly recommend you can check that out if you don't like reading. And conceptually what he does in the book that I thought was just so powerful is like, I've hired you to run the company, make good decisions, go do that. And let me go do the areas I wanna do in this book. And one of the things I love about Ricardo's story was just you hire people, treat them like adults. It's amazing how we have so many meetings and we have all these check-ins and all this stuff. It's like, hire them, pay them well, let them do what they want. And let them do their own thing. Leave them the hell alone. Another thing I loved about this book was employee freedom. A lot of people, Noah, how many hours a week do I have to work and all that stuff? It's like, you choose how many hours a week you work. And there's so much stuff about that where it seems so obvious now, but I love that he got this stuff started. 20 years ago. Another one of my more recent favorite books about how to run your organization better is Work Rules by Laszlo Bock. And I gave it away to a friend, Joe Kelly from Unchained, otherwise I'd have it right here for y'all. And this book is actual real life, how Google hires their people. How do they do their organization? How do they rate their people? How do they comp their people? So if you've started a company or you work at a company, you realize that people really make all the difference. So how do you do your recruiting? So some of the things that this book talks about is what are your KPIs for recruiting? So one of them is what percent of your talent comes in through referrals? And they talk about how to do effective referral recruiting. And something that we're really working on at AppSumo. It's like, how do we get the awesome people that have come to work here to refer other friends? So even some of the messaging that they use in the book kind of help you impact how to improve that. Listen and share information. Let people know, open books, open kimono about how the business is and how decisions are made. That will help people feel excited and appreciate being a part of your organization. That book was fucking fire. Next up, problem number four, how do you become a better leader? There's not like a ton of books on how to be a leader. One of my ones I've really enjoyed is The Score Will Take Care of Itself by Bill Walsh. So it's his memoir on leadership and success from the 49ers. And I remember I read this book, and one of the things that I still do to this day and has been really impactful is that keep your desk clean, people. And I know at AppSumo.com, I'll walk around and look at desks and I'm like, all right, let's try to keep the desk clean. And so what he talks about at a high level about this book and why I found it so impactful is that if you can't control the weather. So what are the actual inputs within your own businesses, which is like how many blog posts do we do? How many YouTube videos do we post? How many emails do we send for our sales? How many calls do we make? And those are the inputs you can actually control. So in your own businesses, as you're starting out or whatever size you're at, think about your actually proactive metrics or leading indicators you can actually be in charge of. Problem number five, how to make long-term strategic decisions. So my book recommendation is Road Less Stupid. Oh, I just gave it away literally this morning by Keith Cunningham. He's actually based here in Austin, Texas. So there's three major takeaways that I really loved about this book that I highly recommend for y'all to think about. Number one is thinking time. Carving out hours, daily, weekly, or whatever you need to really just think. And that's something that like I probably don't do enough of, and I think a lot of us don't. And then as well, as you're doing your thinking time, what are the actual questions that are really gonna give you the right answers? The second thing that I liked about this book is creating dashboards. But what's interesting is how do you check the health of your company in real time? So the way that Keith talks about it, and I love this analogy, is when you're riding a tricycle, you don't need any dials or dashes. You just ride a tricycle. Who's riding tricycles, by the way? Well, you're riding a bicycle. But when you're having a car now you have like a dashboard. Or now when I'm in a plane, there's like a crazy ass dashboard. Or if you're in a jet, there's an even bigger ass dashboard. And so it doesn't mean you need to be tracking everything. But what's interesting is that as things get more complex, you do need to have some dials so as you're making changes across your business, you can see how things are being impacted and how is your own dashboards looking. So I think that's really important. And the last thing that he talks about that really got me excited and what I loved about this book is just how do you create accountability towards outcomes? So at AppSumo.com, to give you an example, we have a sales team, we have a product team, we have a marketing team, we have a customer support team, we have a finance and HR and people team. And so what are the clear outcomes that each team lead and those teams own and let them really facilitate it? And are those metrics of success clear? Problem number six, advanced business tactics to scale your company. So it is the Mastering Rockefeller Habits by Vern Harnish. What happens if you're actually already successful? You're making $100,000 in your side hustle or on your business and you wanna go to the million or 10 million or 100. There's almost no material out there. And this is one of those books that should really help you with that. You wanna be annoying about your key things. So what is your goal? What is your strategy? What is your vision? What is your mission? Whatever things are really important in your business, you have to make it almost annoying. And I forgot I actually got this from this book. So you really wanna be repetitive. Like I know there's posters on walls in corporate ass companies, I'm not saying that, but if you're a leader of a company or if you have a few people, you wanna say like, here's how many customers we want a year. Our GMV number of AppSumo or whatever, our YouTube channel with 250,000 subscribers. If you ask anyone on our YouTube team, it's like 250,000 subscribers, 250,000, we talk about it every single week. So this is a good book. And lastly, problem number seven, how to think outside the box as an entrepreneur. Everyone out there can be an entrepreneur, everyone out there can be creative. And so the Artist Way by Julia Cameron is a book that really reawakens your creativity. One of the stories I've always told myself is that I'm not a creative person. I don't know how to make content really creatively or take photos creatively. And this book was just like, no, you can do it too. It's not exclusive. I was talking to someone earlier today and they're like, how's life? I'm like, honestly, life's amazing. And they're like, what's different? It's my attitude. I have the same friends. I have the same friends. I have the same job. I'm working at AppSumo. I still do content creation. Yes, I live in a different house. But for the most part of my life, the same that it's been for years. It's just the appreciation of how I'm approaching it. And I think this book has definitely been impactful in how I'm thinking about that stuff. So there's really just two main concepts. And she gives a lot of stories about these concepts and a lot of ways for you to think about them and a lot of questions for you to reflect on that I've never heard before. But the two major themes, which is morning pages and artist state. So morning pages, there's no rules. It's literally you wake up, first thing, and you write 3 pages. And that's it every single day. And I have now done it most of this year. And that really helps me make a lot of decisions in the company, in my personal life. Also helps me reflect and feel more appreciative of myself. So I've really been grateful to be inspired by that. And I've heard of journaling forever. Journaling is, by the way, not new. They've been doing it for, what, 10 million years? But just for some reason, just saying, there's no rules. Just do it first thing in the morning. Do at least 3 pages. And they do it by hand. I do it on my iPad. And then you just call it a day. And I love that I've kind of started that habit. The second thing she does is artist date. I have not done this. It's been on my to-dos for months now. I've kind of avoided it, but basically once a week, once a month, go and do something different by yourself in solitude. So nature, go to like a consignment store and buy new clothes, go to a museum, draw something out there that kind of inspires creativity. So here's something to think about. All the books combined are about $100. Now, what kind of investment do you think you'll get even from one of these books? 10,000, million? Billions, whatever that is. It's literally one of the best ways that you can be spending your money to improve your life for now and forever. If you like this video about books and you're curious actually what a day in my life has looked like when I make time to read these books, you're gonna enjoy this video about the CEO of a $100 million company, A Day in My Life. Check it out right up here. And make sure to subscribe to the channel if you're not. Uncle Noah loves you, and I'll see you out there. Pew, pew.